In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to handle retries and failures in a event-driven system when you use a messaging platform like Apache Kafka. But this approach can be applied to any messaging brokers, messaging platforms out there, and goes actually beyond event-driven systems. So in a event-driven system, you would have an event processor which would be consuming, subscribing from a queue or topic, and it would be processing meshes as they come in. And so in this example, you'd have the event processor processing message one. So it would process message one, and if it was successful, it would publish the outcome and acknowledge or commit the message depending on your terminology. And it would also do it for message two. It would consume, process, and publish the outcome. So now what happens if the event processor starts consuming the third message and it suddenly encounters an issue? Well, you could just keep retrying that message. So if you're using something like Apache Kafka, you can't move on to the next message until you've acknowledged, well, committed the consumer's index. So you're just going to keep on processing that same message over and over again unless you do something with it. But if you just commit the offset of the consumer, you're going to lose that message. So what could you do in this case? Well, you could publish the message again to the topic with some additional header information like the retry count, last time it processed, and then put that to the next message. So, but in this example, we've already had a message come in, so the fourth message, and now the retry message is now message five. So after it's published event message five, the retry message, it would then acknowledge and then process message four, and then it would come to message five. But again, it may encounter an issue. So you may do the same thing by publishing it again with additional retry messages and having logic inside the system which would say, if after three retries, push it somewhere else, like ignore it or log it to the database and move on. But it's not a very good technique because you could actually have other event processors, services consuming that event topic as well, and what you're going to be doing is you're going to be polluting that event topic. But a better alternative solution is to actually publish the original message, message three, to a retry topic, and then actually have another event processor, which could be within the same service, consuming that retry topic, processing it, and if it's successful, would publish the result to the same outcome topic. However, you might be thinking, what happens if the retry event processor also encounters an issue? What do you do in this case? Well, the answer is actually quite straightforward, and that is you publish to another retry topic. Yes, stay with me. So let's have a look at the full retry topic solution. So the first retry event processor would fail. It would then publish another message to another retry topic. We've got the second retry event processor. If it can't process, it would then publish another message to another retry topic, and another dedicated retry event process would be consuming that topic, and if it's successful, would again publish to the outcome topic. But if it's failed, now depending on your requirements, if it's failed so many times, you may want to push it to a dead letter queue where meshes which can no longer be processed go. And what you would normally have is you'd normally have a dead letter processor which is consuming that queue, which would be forwarding it, that message, to wherever it needs to be. This could be being stored to a database table, or it could also be at the same time raising a notification to a support team, to an operations team, to a development team to go and investigate. Or it just might publish it to the outcome topic on failure because it can't process and it needs to send the absolute result to the outcome topic and let a downstream service handle that. But you may need to use a dead letter queue, and how I've seen it used before is you'd have the dead letter processor consuming the dead letter queue, storing it to the database, raising a notification, logging an event into a log system, monitoring system, another event could be raised, an email could be sent, which would then go trigger a support team to go and investigate. And you may actually then have a monitoring dashboard built on top of your solution, which allows the ability for operations to investigate what went wrong, and if required, retry that message again for processing. And in that case, you'd have it being published to the first retry topic, not the original event topic, but the first retry, because you're going to retry again. And that is a very simple example of how to retry and handle failed meshes in a event-driven solution. Now, you might be thinking, so we need to have multiple topics for retries and multiple event processes to consume those topics as well. You might be thinking, that's a lot to do. It's not straightforward. Well, no one said event-driven architecture was easy. Event-driven architecture is complex, it's not straightforward, it's not easy. Anyone who says differently is wrong or doesn't know enough about event-driven architecture.